James Wiseman was one of the most mysterious yet intriguing NBA draft prospects in the 2020 class. The Golden State Warriors took a chance by drafting him at number 2, but so far in his career, he's gone through ups and downs and is still looking for consistency. Join us now as we take a look at how good James Wiseman actually is. When the Golden State Warriors won the number 2 selection in the 2020 NBA draft, the entire league knew what that meant. James Wiseman was on his way to the Bay Area. The Minnesota Timberwolves, who had the number 1 pick, already had a franchise center in Karl Anthony Towns, so it didn't make sense for them to draft a 7-footer. What made way too much sense was the Warriors drafting Wiseman, as they had a starting lineup with really good players on every position except at the center spot. Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, Andrew Wiggins, Draymond Green, all of these guys are either borderline stars or superstar players. Adding the best big man of the new draft class was supposed to turn the Warriors into the Western Conference powerhouse that would go head-to-head with the Los Angeles Lakers. But then Klay Thompson got injured and was lost for the season. As devastating as this injury may have been for the Warriors' season, it may have also been a blessing in disguise of sorts. Because thanks to this, we've got a chance to see and better assess the game of James Wiseman. It's rare for a team as stacked as the Warriors to earn such a high selection in the draft, but that was the result of an unexpected 15-50 season last year after Golden State made 5 straight trips to the NBA Finals. And it's even rarer for a rookie to immediately become a starter for a championship-contending team. And that's exactly what would have happened if Klay Thompson had been able to start the 2020-21 regular season healthy, but he couldn't. Thompson's absence forces everybody on the team, especially the starters, to play at a better level than expected, which obviously includes Wiseman. There's already huge pressure on his back to perform well given he was the 2nd pick in the draft, and that pressure gets doubled considering the Warriors fanbase expects him to contribute right away. That's quite the heavy load for a 19-year-old youngster who appeared in only 3 college games and had to sit through training camp due to health protocols. When a team is winning, their collective and individual flaws and issues are all hidden by their success. You don't have to go too far back for an example of this. Just look at what happened to these same Warriors 2 years ago. The team was imploding in the middle of rumors about Kevin Durant leaving in free agency and how much they were struggling when Steph Curry and Draymond Green were out injured. They were still winning and eventually got to the NBA Finals, but after that, everything went south. That's how the franchise ended up with that horrific 15-50 record last year. Saying all eyes are on Wiseman when Golden State's on the court might sound like a bit of an overstatement when you have Steph Curry running the show simultaneously, but that's kind of the case. The Warrior situation forces us to be more critical on Wiseman, but as we said earlier, it's more beneficial for him long term if he faces the criticism and scrutiny early on, instead of having his flaws covered by the Warrior's success. So let's take a deep look at how good James Wiseman actually is at this moment in time, and how his future looks. But before we do, make sure to comment down below if you think the Warriors made the right choice by picking James Wiseman 2nd in the 2020 draft. James Wiseman's NBA career up to this point has been a roller coaster of ups and downs. He can have an amazing game on one night, then have an awful performance on the very next game. Take for instance the Warriors' recent shocker win against the Los Angeles Lakers. Golden State pulled off a surprising win, but Wiseman had a horrible night with 5 fouls and 5 turnovers in just 13 minutes of action. He came back 2 nights later and had his best game of the season, scoring 20 points, grabbing 6 rebounds, and dishing 4 assists, while shooting 8 for 11 from the field and not committing any turnovers. Also, he remained out of foul trouble for most of the contest before picking up a couple fouls late when the game was already in hand, as he played almost 26 minutes. We all know rookies are often inconsistent, but you can't have 2 performances as polar opposite as those Wiseman delivered in this pair of games. Offensively, Wiseman has played like a very solid, traditional center. He's shooting 74% at the rim, which is a top 10 mark among bigs who have attempted at least 40 shots at the rim. That's really good for a rookie, but that's as good as it gets. Out of there, he's shooting 4 for 13 from 3, taking less than 1 shot per game, and 17 for 53 from the mid-range area. It's certainly encouraging to see him taking jump shots, as it shows he's willing to expand his mid-range beyond the paint, but his percentages so far haven't been ideal outside of rim shots. He's mostly a non-factor playmaking-wise and doesn't have the vision to hit cutters or open shooters consistently. Centers in recent Golden State Warriors history were cut from the exact same cloth. Traditional bigs who can set hard screens, catch alley-oops, and play good paint defense, that's it. The Warriors don't need their centers to be shooting threes or posting up with their back to the basket. They already have a plethora of shooters and slashers that can do all that. Golden State centers aren't asked to do much outside of the dirty work. And as it turns out, the team now has to incorporate a more versatile and capable big that can do more than what any of their previous centers, from Andrew Bogut to Zaza Pachulia, could do. The question is, should the Warriors continue being this stubborn and trying to rush Wiseman into finding a good fit with the team? Or should they just stick to what's worked and try to find Wiseman a new home? As we often say about rookies, Wiseman has really struggled with consistency. A big part of these struggles is how foul-prone he is. Wiseman is averaging 3.5 personal fouls in just under 21 minutes a night. There aren't words that can express how bad that is. But that rate has Wiseman averaging 6 fouls per 36 minutes. That basically makes him unreliable and unplayable because he hasn't been able to stay on the court consistently. Even if he's proven to be a good paint scorer, that's useless if he can't stay on the court. And even though he still has a long way to go on both ends, head coach Steve Kerr really trusts him and wants to give him a lot of opportunities to shine. Many people have criticized Kerr for running a suboptimal starting lineup that features very little shooting around Steph Curry. Other than Andrew Wiggins, who's having a career year from behind the three-point arc, there are no shooters out there. That complicates things for Curry and therefore everybody else on offense. Apparently, this was the plan all along from Kerr, who's willing to face some struggles early on in the season if this helps new players like Wiseman get used to each other on both ends. The team is learning on the fly, Kerr commented before saying something Warriors fans thought he was ignoring. I'll be very honest, if I had to win a game tomorrow, I wouldn't start that group. If this was a one-time thing, I would start a different group and probably get to some different combinations. So why is Steve Kerr not running a starting lineup with better chemistry to try and win more? This is the team that I want to see develop a really good defensive identity, and James needs to be out there, Kerr said. It's going to take some time, and in the meantime, there's going to be some growing pains. But I'm okay with it, because for us to be great down the road, whether it's by the end of this year or even next season, James has to develop, and Kelly and Andrew have to get comfortable, and I'm willing to sacrifice some things here early in the season to get where we want to be later on. This must be music to Wiseman's ears, because teams with championship aspirations usually don't have the time for experimenting or waiting on a rookie. His defense inside the paint has been solid, but the issues start when he's pulled farther away from the basket. He's still more of a traditional big man than a modern-day big, which isn't that bad, but it's important for the Warriors to keep in mind for them to be at their most dangerous form, they need players who don't have any issues switching on defense. That's how their death lineup from years past was so dangerous. Andre Iguodala was subbed in for whichever center was on the court, sliding Draymond Green down one position, and it made Golden State very hard to beat on the defensive end. One of the reasons Wiseman has been kept out of games late in the clutch this year is because he isn't switchable. Add in the fact he's fouling at league-high rates, and it's hard for him to remain on the court. Again, he's been a solid enough defender in the paint, but if he's hacking players every time they drive towards the basket, he can be an easy target for opposing teams. A lot of this bad fouling has to do with mistimed jumping, bad help, IQ, and trying to go for blocks way too late. Thankfully, Wiseman is teammates with one of the best defenders of all time and a former Defensive Player of the Year in Draymond Green. The rookie said how helpful Green has been to him as a mentor, especially on the defensive end. Listening to Draymond, talking to Draymond, Wiseman said, he's giving me little tricks, different tricks on how to be smart, how to stay on my feet, because I'm 7'1", so I don't have to jump. So if I'm going to jump, be the second jumper. But just like using verticality, which I'm getting better at. Green is a known vocal leader, but he's particularly taken Wiseman under his wing. This has led to multiple instances where the teacher shows some tough love to the student with screams and sermons. Draymond isn't the only member of the team who has Wiseman's back. As we've seen, Steve Kerr and also Stephen Curry express support for the young fella. You throw him out there and then you remind him that no matter how many times he looks at it or we tell him, it's just going to be reps, the Warriors coach said. That's what I told him after last game. There's just going to be good games, bad games. The main thing is just to continue to work and continue to learn. It's right up there with the ones that have the it factor, Curry said about Wiseman's confidence in himself. Obviously, it comes with a sense of expectation around playing for us and being the second draft pick. The two-time MVP couldn't have put it better, as he's happy to see Wiseman putting in the work, asking questions, and looking to get better every day. So, how good is James Wiseman actually? This is a two-part answer. As we've discussed throughout today's video, Wiseman as a player is a really solid young player who can excel scoring inside the paint and playing interior defense. But Wiseman as a member of the Warriors doesn't look like the greatest fit. especially because Golden State's team takes a hit with a back-to-the-basket playstyle and lack of ball movement. The Warriors are doing everything in their power to integrate Wiseman as best as they can, and no other team gives him access to amazing mentors like Draymond Green and Stephen Curry. What's also true is the Warriors are in more of a win-now mode and may not be in the best position to be patient and wait for the rookie to develop. There's no doubt Wiseman will be a really good center in a couple of years. His developing jumper gives hope that he'll eventually play more like a modern-day big that will also be a force inside the paint on both ends. What's not entirely clear is if the Warriors are the best place for him to develop, and making that decision on whether it's best for him to remain in the Bay Area may be the difference between Wiseman becoming just a good starting center and becoming one of the best centers in the league. Do you think Wiseman can become a top 5 center in the NBA later in his career? What do you think is Wiseman's ceiling? Let us know what you think in the comments down below. And as always, don't forget to leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel.